everyone. In this video, I'm going to be talking about proven demons again. Well, since the last video, I have had people come to me showing me more evidence of things that he has done in his other videos, doing his paranormal investigations. And I want to show you what type of person he is, and the things that he is doing that are so wrong. So I've made clips from a couple videos, and I will be showing them. Okay, and in this first clip, he's talking about how he feels it's morally wrong for him to be doing this. So let's get started.
Is it morally right to dig into a suspected grave?
No. You know your answer. No. It's not right. Okay.
Oh, God. I literally feel like I'm going crazy. I want to know what's in there, you know?
This is you. This is the spirit of the child what resides here. Oh my God.
Okay. Oh, that is epic. I just want answers here. That's all I want.
Well, your answers are no. No, it's not right. No, you shouldn't be doing it. And you already know this. This is just the introduction to his video. Okay? Even if it's a suspected grave or any of the thing like that, you should call authorities and let them take care of it if you feel like there's something there that shouldn't be. Alright, let's go to the next video.
Honestly, I think the only thing that has stopped me from moving forward from this point is the question. You know, is it morally right to dig into a suspected grave? Even if it's unmarked or the purpose is to try and help someone, to try and uncover a mystery or...
To help them, you call the authorities and let them take care of it. You don't do what you're doing in this video. Watch and see, people.
Find something that's really not supposed to be there that's been forgotten about. Is it morally right to do so?
No. No, it's not morally right at all. And you know the answer to that question. And you're acting like, oh... I need your guys' opinion. Please. Okay, next video.
So you believe there's a child here, and we have what appears to be a kid's grave. Do we continue, or is it too much?
I think we continue, but because it's like someone's trying to show us a sign.
Okay. Turn on the light. Let's flood the room.
I cannot believe what just happened there with the K2. Just as I asked, was there a spirit of a young child here? It immediately fell over. How crazy is that? Spiking again.
Spiking.
So this is where he thinks that he is standing over a grave, so he starts to dig into it. Who in their right mind thinks this is okay? This is what you should do. If you think there's a grave there and it's not supposed to be there, you call the police and let the police take care of that. You don't go start digging, for one. Plus, it's not your property to be digging on. That property belongs to somebody else. Just because it's abandoned doesn't mean you're allowed to go in there and just start digging and tearing stuff up. The hole in the wall you put there. That's terrible. Okay, next video. First attempt.
So obviously, Proven Demons are doing the live stream, and I'm actually recording a proper episode.
Now let me remind you people, this is where he starts digging the hole through the wall. to get to the other side. Okay? This is not his property. This is an abandoned property that belongs to somebody else. And he's digging a hole through the wall.
Yeah, I'm gonna do the episode anyway. It's just a mystery episode. Plus an explore.
I mean, you're an abandoned building after all. So that makes it okay. Wow. With no luck but the wall opening up much further, we go in for one last attempt and you won't believe what we found. Okay. Night of final attempt.
Well, guys, you wanted it. A lot of you got upset with me that I left a cliffhanger to it, so tonight we are finishing the wall. Obviously, it's me and Olivia, but we're also here with your boy Dan and Wheaton.
All of you guys should be ashamed of yourselves, every one of you.
You guys wanted it so bad, and Dan and everyone was so excited to get this done, that even though I currently have food poisoning, I even made a point to be out here.
Maybe that's karma, Andrew. Maybe that's karma. You have food poisoning. Maybe it was trying to stop you from going to do the ignorance that you were doing. Think about it. And then you're talking about, is this morally wrong? Maybe karma's biting you right in the ass. I don't know.
You're at about midnight right now. Spend the whole night getting through this wall. See if the spirit box is right and there really was a body behind.
Yeah. Well, maybe if you're sick, you should have stayed home. That would have been the smart thing to do. And the other smart thing to do was to leave that property alone. It's not yours to tear up and bust through walls. Really, it's not. Alright, in this next video, I'm pretty sure this is the one where he finds bones. So here we go.
What the f-? Don't touch that. This is now a crime scene.
Yeah, it's a crime scene when you started busting a hole through the wall. That was a crime scene. Now listen, guys. Listen to what they're saying here.
What's that? Is that an arm?
One of them says, I'm out. Why? Because he knows they were doing wrong. He's out. He's not getting involved.
What the f-? Yeah. Okay. Alright.
Why do you need to take your memory cards out? And all your footage, why you gotta hide it? Because you know you were not supposed to be in there doing what you're doing? Is that why you're hiding everything? Well, unfortunately, you uploaded it to the internet, so somebody can report you. And you're still gonna get in trouble. I am surprised you haven't been in trouble yet, because the shit you're doing is ridiculous. Here we go. Next video. This is where he calls the cops. One of them called the cops.
Hi, my name is Dan. I'm an urban explorer. I'm currently in an abandoned property and we think we find human remains. Hi, my name's Dan. I'm an urban explorer, and I'm currently in an abandoned location in Cheshire, I think it is. And we think we found human remains.
Sorry, you can't
1 minute, I'll just check my math. We just go around taking pictures of abandoned wood.
We just go around taking pictures of abandoned locations, and I forgot to tell you that we also destroy them, tear them up, bust through walls. We forgot to tell you that part. Oops!
Well, we're currently in the property, but I'm gonna stand on the road. We parked on the road. We're literally just outside it.
Which property are you outside?
Oh, sorry. It's a really derelict looking house. I don't know if it's got a number on it.
Probably not.
There's no number, but it's a really, all the windows are gone and it's all broken.
It's broken because they're breaking it. They're going in destroying stuff. And for the people that actually go in these buildings and these locations and urban explore, without tearing things up, you're ruining it for them. You're ruining it for anybody else that wants to do something like this without tearing things up. Some people just like to go in and see the architecture of a place and how it was built and stuff like that. And they don't touch things. They don't dig through walls, dig holes in the ground that supposedly has a grave. They don't do things like that. But they enjoy going out doing exactly what you're doing without the destruction. It just baffles me how you guys think. It does. It really just baffles me.
And it's right. It's we're actually parked on the corner. We take pictures of like run-down properties and abandoned places, and we do ghost hunting and stuff like that as well.
These pictures are
See, he forgets to tell them that we also dig holes through the walls and destroy the place. He forgot to tell them about that, didn't he? Oops. Come on, man. Be honest with them.
Human bones.
Well,
we believe to be a human bone. Like one, you know, like a big bone. It doesn't like an animal bone.
Yeah. It doesn't look like an animal bone. And see, here's what gets me about this. These are grown adults. Now, I can see a teenager, you know, silly little teenager going in, doing things that they're doing, destroying things. But these are grown adults doing this. This is not how you do paranormal research or ghost hunting. You don't have to do none of this. You know, and if you suspect it being a grave that isn't supposed to be there, you contact authorities. You don't go digging and finding out for yourself. That's just not cool. Especially when the property does not belong to you. You leave it alone. It's okay to go in and look. But you don't have to touchy-touchy. Didn't anybody's mother teach them? No touch. If it don't belong to you, don't touch it. I'm pretty sure they did.
We're waiting in the car for apparently Sergeant in the corner and everything to arrive. It's pretty crazy. Thing is, they didn't want us to film. They asked us if we were filming. We're worried that they're gonna take our film.
They should take more than your film. They should take your asses to jail. My opinion. Only my opinion. But hey, you know, there's consequences to actions, and I hope you get them. I really do. Yeah, you don't want them to take all the footage, all the evidence of what you were doing wrong. I hope they do get a hold of it. And I hope actions are taken. Consequences to your actions. Really not safe now. Shit, you're tearing down the walls. How safe is it going to be when you're tearing the place up? You're making it even more dangerous for anybody else that enters the building. Common sense. Hello. No. No, it's not safe for you to go in there. Your better bet's probably to stay out of there, too. It's hard telling the damage they've already done. So, yeah. I don't get where you think this is okay, Andrew. Now, everyone, there's a way to go out and do paranormal research and ghost hunting. There's ways to do it without having to go in and tear things up. Don't think it's okay and you're always going to get by with going in and destroying things and messing around in graves and tombs and things like that. You're not going to always get by with it. You shouldn't be doing it, period. If you had any morals and any heart at all, you would leave that kind of stuff alone. If you're going into abandoned buildings, just because they're abandoned does not mean that somebody does not own them. Doesn't mean that they want somebody in there just tearing things up. Go in and look. Do your footage. Don't touch things. You're grown. You know better. You know, I didn't want to have to make another video, but the more stuff I keep getting from people to view, the worse it's getting. I mean, I can't believe people are actually following this kind of content and thinking that it's okay. It's not. This is only my opinion. This is how I feel about it. This doesn't reflect on anybody else's opinions. So, I am going to conclude this video. Thank you guys for watching. Please, if you go out doing urbex exploring, paranormal research, ghost hunting, whatever you're doing, don't destroy things. Don't go digging up graves. Don't go playing with bones. Do it the right way. Just leave things alone. Have a good day.